Thank you. Nice full house. Wonderful to see you all. Welcome, everybody. How are we doing tonight? So great to see you all. Thank you so much. Did Ashley introduce the band?
No.
All right, here they are. This is Miss Ashley Way on piano. You all know Ashley. And Lewis Redner on bass. And Mr. Kelby McNair on drums. And we're just so happy to be this configuration once again. We're going to have fun tonight. Those of you that are viewing from home, thank you so much for checking in. And without further ado, this was one of the first songs that connected Dion and Mr. Bacharach together. She sort of said, "Now don't make me over." And then away they went. Don't make me over. Thank you so much. These folks are just so, so fun to play with. All right. We're going to slow it down just a little bit. Just a little bit. Thank you all for your attendance tonight. It's just so nice to see so many familiar faces and so many new faces, too. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. How you doing?
Ooh, I like that. How you doing?
All right. What happens here?
Fun thing.
I know what's going to happen. We have a few very, very special guests this evening, and some of you, many of you will know Brian Tate, was from the mainland and is now in Victoria with his beautiful wife, Patricia. And he's leading choirs as ever and composing as ever, and he's gonna sing as ever. Come on up, Brian, please. Big warm welcome for Mr. Brian Tate. And I'm gonna disappear.
Thank you, Lorraine. Thank you for kindly inviting me to be a part of this evening with such a wonderful group of musicians. Thank you all for coming out tonight. I'm doing a song from 1969 from a movie that Burt Bacharach wrote a theme song and the score for called The April Fools. How many remember that film? I didn't think so. It wasn't a terribly memorable film, but it's a fabulously memorable theme song. So this is The April Fools.
Once you came to me,
Thank you. Thank you so much. And now I get to do a duet, so let's welcome Lorraine back to the stage.
Brendan, can I please have just a little bit more monitor for me? This is a nice song that I was driving my mother to some appointment and it came on the radio and I was quite surprised. She said, I love this song. And so I had to learn it very, very quickly. And so it came into my repertoire this spring. And I'm just so happy to be able to do it now with Mr. Brian Tate.
Yeah. I'm glad I get the chance to say that I do believe I love you, and I should ever go away. Well, then close your eyes and try to feel the way we do today. And then if you can remember, keep smiling, keep shining.
Oh,
Now I don't want him to go sit down. He should just stay up here. Mr. Brian Tate. Fabulous, eh? And we'll see lots more Brian in just a few minutes, so hang on to your seats. Oh, who's joined us on stage here? It's Mr. Roy Stife. Big warm welcome to Mr. Roy Stife on saxophone this evening. We're so excited to have him here. Thank you so much. Woo! I don't want you to go now.
Don't ever go.
Maybe just stay. I don't know. But then it's up to Patrick. Yeah. All right. It is your turn, isn't it? We have color-coded names. Who's up next? Patrick is green. Do you know why? I don't know. It was a fluke. I hit green. All right, we'll have Roy back. Are you going to stay on? Maybe I'll just go in the back and you guys play. Studied. How many of you love Robert Redford and Paul Newman? So Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, and this was the tune that was written, and several people on the set said, that's really dumb, it shouldn't be in the movie, but the director insisted it should be, and turned out they all loved it, and we love the scene where Paul Newman is riding his bicycle, and he's got the beautiful girl on his basket, and such a good time. We should all pedal our bikes like that in the field, and good luck. All right, so here we go. Mr. Patrick Boyle, Mr. Roy Stife. Thank you. my head. And just like a guy whose feet are too big for his bed, nothing seems to fit. Those raindrops keep falling on my head, they keep falling. So I just did me some talking to the sun. And I said I didn't like the way he got things done, all sleeping on the job. Those raindrops keep falling on my head, they keep falling. There's one thing. Sit down yet. How's everybody doing? Doing okay? Big shout out for our sound crew here and our waiting staff and all the folks on Arts and Youth Society. Yeah. And then all of you that show up, right? If you weren't here, this would look pretty silly what we're doing, but thank you so much for your attendance and your good energy. Lots of really nice smiles. I appreciate it. This next song is a bit slower and a bit sadder, and that's okay. I like ballads. Even when so much. This is the last one of this first set. Is it perfect timing? Is that a good, that's a good song, but it's not a Burt Bacharach tune, so we can't do it. Okay. you talked about movies earlier. Brian talked about movies earlier. So many of these were movie themes, and I just wanted to kind of comment on what was going on in the 70s. I don't know if you were around, but I was around. Women's liberation and sexual liberation, all those things. And so all these wacky movies of kind of wild scenarios, right? Of, and they popped the champagne at that same time. So Arthur's theme from the movie Arthur was about this very, very rich kid, and the parents said, oh, you got to marry the rich girl because that's going to make our company big and famous and whatever. But he didn't like the rich girl. But he just wanted to play and have fun. And then he fell in love with a poor girl. And so there you go. That's the premise. Here we go.
Once in your life, you
Mr. Roy Stipe on saxophone, Happy McNair, Louis Redner, Ms. Ashley Way, and thank you, Brian, who will come back, and Patrick as well, that will come back in the second set. I have one announcement. I'm sorry, I didn't have time to make a little poster. So for the poster, I had a really fun time with the collaging all of the song titles, and I made I'm gonna call it a painting, okay? It's really cool, and I had so much fun. I did two more small ones. And then tomorrow is Truth and Reconciliation Day, so I thought if I could sell those for a really good price, then I would give the money to the Victoria Native Friendship Center. I thought that'd be a really cool thing. So I don't know if my beloved Dave made a little poster or not. I asked him to in the car. We were in different cars. okay, so the big one is 150 and the little ones are 75 or proximally. You know,
where are they?
They're in the hall. They're really cool.
I saw them. Cool.
They're very cool. Anyway, the money's going to go to Victoria the Native Friendship Society. And I think that's what we can do. Little thing. Okay? Mm-hmm. Have a great break. We'll see you in a little bit.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
that the canvases didn't sell, so we'll take the lowest bid will be $10 for the canvases out front. The lowest bid will be $10, and all the proceeds will go to the Victoria Native Friendship Center. And they're just, it's a couple little canvases, and all the titles of the songs, I made them in different fonts, and I cut them out, and I painted a canvas, and then I glued them, and it was pretty phenomenal. So please, buy this piece of art. Just give some money to one of the volunteers, and thank you to the volunteers. And our door people are volunteers. Give what you think it's worth, and I'll forward that to the Victoria Native Friendship Society. Okay, Truth and Reconciliation tomorrow. Every day, not tomorrow, every day. Okay, do you guys want to do a bass and horn? Patricia. Thank you so much for your patience. It's so good to see you all here this evening, and we will begin our second set with this tune that I wish I was Sheryl Crow in the White House singing this. She's so hot. She's got this mini, and she goes like this with her heel. That's all she does. She's so great, but I'm not going to do that. Here we go. Start to cry each time we meet. So please join your local choir. Okay. Speaking of which.
There are more choirs in Victoria, I swear to the Lord, baby Jesus Christ, than anywhere in the world, hey?
There's more singers. So
more
many singers. So great. This next song was sort of a pick-me-up for a lot of the American soldiers that were fighting. And so they made a happy little tune just to know that the home folks were thinking of them. Thank you. believe me. For me, there is no one. He'll just stay on the stage, okay? And next we're gonna call Mr. Brian Tate back up to the stage. Big hand for Brian Tate. Did you clap big time when Patrick left the stage? Did we decide Roy was gonna come up on this one or not? Thank you so much. Yeah, Mr. Brian Tick. All right. Here he comes. Okay, Mr. Roy Steiff is going to join us. Is it okay? We're playing a little bit of magical, what is it? Not
musical,
musical chairs, musical microphones, or musical stage. Now, what was this one from? Do you see this girl? Was it a movie? Okay, here's the quiz. What was the purpose for this girl's in love with you? Was that a movie? This guy's in love with you. Put your ballots. Ballots are just $5 each, and all proceeds.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Roy Stipe. Okay, apparently we're good for time. Were you going to stick around for Alfie or not?
Well.
Yeah. Oh, yeah?
Yes, it's all right. Okay.
Oh, yeah?
Okay.
Do you have it?
You're
I
got gonna
it.
Play Alfie?
Okay. Yeah? You don't mind?
I'm just talking to you. It was quite an exceptional.
Yes, apparently. Do you want to be the start? I'm going to go sit down for a minute.
What a great song, Alfie. I mean, they're all great.
So this one, too, as a little girl, I didn't know what this was about, but it was a gigolo, and it was a movie, Alfie, and he was not Rex Harrison. Who?
Jude Law.
Oh, that's got to be the new version. No, that's the new version. Thank you, Michael Caine.
One vote for Michael Caine.
Yes.
Your ballots are just $5. All right, Mr. Roy Stipe is going to take us into Alfie, please. To be kind. good, but I worry about the timeness. Okay.
All we have is time, Lorraine.
All we have is time? Okay.
Somebody's having a good time.
That's, yeah.
Well, upstairs, right. Actually 27 minutes ago.
Brian, you're up for one more. Big hand for Brian Tate. Here we go. So this one, this is interesting because and we have to talk about the fact that the 70s was all about finally you can divorce people and that became a free and cool thing. So Burt Bacharach and his wife were separating and they came up with this terrific song. They worked on the lyrics together. I think it's pretty cool. And then Michael McDonald and they added some more just to make it a bigger song. I wish that we could start it all again. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I really do worry. We're starting. Should we do our big final number?
Yeah, sure.
Because we're supposed to finish at 9. I know we all have a curfew. No? Pardon? Oh, okay. So, Patrick, how about we do that? Let's do that. Okay. All right. Oh, yeah, we need to do that. Patrick, do you want to do the always something there to remind me?
Give it up for Brian. Yeah.
Brian, take it. Woohoo!
Thank you.
All right, thank you so very much. Come on to the stage. Roy and Brian, come up for a big bow. Thank you so much, everybody. You have been a phenomenal audience. We're so, so very, very grateful. Mr. Brian Tate, Ashley Way, Patrick Coyle, Lewis Redner, Kelby McNair, and Roy Stye. Thank you so very, very much.
Hey, how about for Lorraine Nygaard, everybody? It's Lorraine Nygaard.
Mountains and hillsides.
And go sing that out in the world. Shine your light and spread your love. That's what the world needs now. Thank you all so very, very much for your attendance and good energy this evening. Good night, all.